Well, good morning.
Good morning.
My name is Kevin Lee. On behalf of Tammy and Ron, my colleagues at Mid-America Transplant, we're here to say thank you this morning. April is Donate Life Month. It's a month we really highlight all of those across the country who are waiting for a life-saving transplant. Over 115,000 Americans today wait for that call. That actually happened here last September through the courageous actions of Melissa and her family on behalf of honoring Dakota's desire to be a hero to save lives through organ donation and the incredible work of the clinical team here. Your efforts together combined saved two lives through kidney transplantation at Barnes Jewish Hospital in St. Louis. So thank you for that. Thank you for being part of that. Melissa, we can't say thank you enough to you and your family for those courageous actions on behalf of Dakota, honoring his intent to be a hero. In organ and tissue donation, we talk about heroes all the time. And we look across our communities, we really look at three types of heroes. We look at veterans, we look at first responders, we look at organ, tissue, and eye donors, those who sacrifice for the complete stranger to save the lives of others who they've never known. So thank you for those courageous actions that you took as well. On behalf of our team, the team in Hannibal Regional, we'd like to present you with the Shadow Box and the Donor Memorial Medal. We hope you'll display it with pride, remembering the two lives that Dakota saved through organ donation.
We appreciate this so much. I think it's important for everybody to know that Dakota made the choice. We just followed his wishes. And so I'm so proud. He's my hero because that he had already made that choice much before we had to. And I think that's important that people not only make a choice, but they make sure that everybody knows that what their wishes is. Because when you're in the face of tragedy like that, that it's hard to think or to make decisions like that. So make sure that everybody is aware of your wishes to be an organ donor. Our choice wasn't hard because our lives have been touched on the donor and the recipient. And we have I have a nephew who is 21 years old who is on dialysis and in need of a kidney transplant. And so, you know, it wasn't a hard choice, I'm sure, for Dakota, which is, I'm sure, why he made his decision that he did it. It wasn't a hard choice for us. So it's just so important that everybody make the decision to do so. The team here and at the hospital, Dr. Parikh and the nurses, and Wendy, our transplant coordinator, done everything right, made it so easy for us. The aftercare that we've received since then, the letters, the check-ins. I was telling somebody upstairs that when we left the funeral home the next day, that the first call I got was from Wendy, our transplant coordinator, letting us know that the transplants went fine and that both recipients were healthy and doing well. And so that was so important, and the follow-up that we've got since then has been so amazing. So the nurses, many of them never left our sides, many of them showed up at Dakota's visitation, things like that. Interesting story was when they took us downstairs and removed everything, I can remember sitting around the table, and only one time did I ever look up from the table, and I think the nurses were crying harder than we were. And I remember looking down, back out at Dakota, thinking, what a perfect moment. You know, what a perfect moment. What a hero, and just what a gift that he not only gave his recipients, but gave his family. Because in the midst of tragedy, something so beautiful happened, and that gives you so much more comfort and peace when you're losing somebody like your 26-year-old son. So I just appreciate this so much. I know my family does. I'm so proud of Hannibal Regional Hospital. I haven't spoke about Dakota's death or anything, but when somebody, you called and said, would you come to the hospital and speak about this, I said, absolutely, because this is my town, and this is my home. hospital. These are my people, and I'm just so proud of them and their ability to do what they do, because it can't be any easier on them than it is on the families most of the time. So thank you so much for this. We have heard from our recipients. I heard from one of them, and he's doing fine. I haven't heard from the other. I'll maybe contact him someday, but he's doing fine, has a family and children, and back to enjoying life. And so that gives you so much comfort. So everybody be a hero. Sign your license. Let your family members know that you want to be a hero and that you want to donate. Make sure you have the conversation. Make sure they understand what you want. And then make sure you follow through, because lives are saved. And my son is a perfect example of how, in the face of tragedy, you can save somebody's life. So thank you guys so much. Thank you to the hospital and to Mid-America. And thank you guys. I just